My friends, welcome to the broadcast. You are listening to Eric the Freedom Screamer on the Republic Broadcasting Network. Thanks for joining us tonight. That was Eric Clapton. This is Eric the Freedom Screamer. We got a fantastic broadcast lined up tonight. We have Lori Anderson coming on air in a few minutes, or if not sooner. We got Lori, and we also have John Lamb. John Lamb's going to give us some updates on the trials in Nevada, and oh boy, I would hope there's some good news there. We'll just see if John has any. We're prepared for the worst, but we hope for the best. This broadcast stands on Psalms 94:16, which is the activism psalm, what I call it. It's who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity? Who? I will. Will you? Thanks for joining us tonight. If you'd like to join the broadcast, it's 800-313-9443. For starters, go to courtroomwatch.com and get yourself a stack of jury nullification flyers and start passing them out to everybody in your community. When you get dragged, if and when you get dragged into the witch's court by the street Nazis, you will be very happy that somebody on that jury knew about jury nullification. All it takes is one. We need patriots with guts to do this. It's a high return, low risk activist. Flyers. I hear a little noise in the background. Who do we got? We're trying for Gary, Lori, John Lamb. I think Chris is going to be maybe on hiatus for a few days. We're having some issues with his phone. I'm going to try to get through to him tomorrow. So Chris may or may not, but definitely Lori, John, and Gary. Who do we have so far? I hear a little scurrying going on there in the background. Do we have Lori or John? Gary?
Can you hear me?
Oh, Lori, how are you?
Oh, my God. Everything completely froze on three computers, guys.
Oh, geez, go figure. We've been working all week, and now it suddenly freeze on us. Okay, well, that just validates what we're talking about here is the truth on the Republic Broadcasting Network. Go ahead, Lori.
Oh, wow. Hallelujah. How is everyone this evening?
Hanging in there. Hanging in there.
Good.
We're glad you could join us tonight. We've been woefully missing you. We're looking forward to your presence tonight. I know you've been a busy girl. But, yes. You know, doing your thing with the children, grandchildren, other people's children, and the whole nursery daycare center thing. So how is Lori's daycare? And what do we have for us tonight, Lori? I hear we have a special treat, possibly John Lamb.
We do. We have some really interesting information, and I don't want to give out too much because I want John to be able to tell us. But first, we're going to hear a couple of words that Carol Bundy stated. Yesterday, she made a statement, and it's about 3 minutes and 50 seconds. And then we're going to pull John Lamb on, who has been in Las Vegas, Nevada, at the federal courthouse while the Bundy trials have been going on. And now they are in jury deliberations, and some really interesting facts are definitely coming to light, and some interesting information is also coming out. So I wanted to have John share that with everyone, because as you know, you won't hear about the nitty-gritty real truth on most broadcasts anyway. So with that being said, if you could go ahead and play the clip, and then we will pull on John Lamb, who has so wonderfully, him and Andrea Parker and other individuals have so wonderfully been staying up there for the verdict watch of the jury and what is going on. The courtroom observations have been imperative for what is going on. As you well know, Eric, it is very important to have that courtroom observation on there, because otherwise it is not going to get out. The truth is not going to get out. And we can't thank the individuals enough for not only observing, but of course keeping everyone informed so that we can keep our listeners informed. I would say. So if you could go ahead and play the clip. This is Carol Bundy yesterday speaking on a statement about lies being told and the truth being suppressed.
In 2014, my family took a peaceful stand against government's overreach, and the people from across the nation came and stood by our side. Our request throughout the whole protest was that it remain peaceful, and it did. Those people saved our lives that day against the heavy-handedness of our federal government. Now, today, 19 innocent men set in prison because they stood for truth and righteousness and our constitutional rights. They have been denied any and all of those precious rights. You are all witnesses to a judge and prosecuting attorneys who have no bounds, who do not honor their oath of office, have total disregard for the U.S. Constitution. There is no justice to be found in that courtroom. President Trump, you remain silent. Mr. Jeff Sessions, you said you were pleased with the prosecution. Is this how you think the courts under your jurisdiction should be ran? You too, sir, have no disregard for the U.S. Constitution, as well as your oath of office. Shame on you. Mr. Zinke, you came to the Bundy Ranch and toured my ranching area. You never reached out to us. You said it was now out of your jurisdiction. You were right. We are part of the sovereign state of Nevada, and you have no business in this great state. However, you claim over 89% of our land. Who put us in the judicial courts? You did. And who can take us out of those courts? You can, sir. You can drop all charges, and we will no longer be in the judicial system. Shame on you. Nevada is a battle-born state. Governor Sandoval and Attorney General Laxalt, many have reached out to you, and yet you remain silent. Where are you? There's a battle raging in your great state. I believe that all of you glean your information from the fake news media, and not one of you have replied or reached out to those of us who know the truth and our intent. I believe in the power of the jury. They have a huge decision to make as they continue to deliberate. Their verdict determines not only the future of these innocent men and their families, but it will set a huge precedence for all Americans that exercise their constitutional rights and freedoms. Jury members, do you realize that even one drop of doubt proves innocence? Google jury nullification. Know and learn your rights. Do you realize that if they are found guilty of even one of these crimes, they will spend the rest of their life in prison? These are innocent men. No victim, no crime. I believe that God is the only one who can make this right. Pray for divine intervention. Pray for the jury, that they will have their hearts open to understanding and their eyes to see the truth that was not presented in the courtroom. Lies were told, truth was denied. Pray for the jury to know the truth and to have the courage to stand for that truth. For the truth shall set these innocent men free. I call for we the people of America today, all of us, you and me, everybody. Now is the time to pray for truth, pray for liberty, pray for freedom, and pray for America. America, we must live on our knees so we can fight on our feet. Now we have one heck of a job to do. Let's get her done.
All right. So with that,
yeah, well, we continue. Anybody there? I'm here. I don't hear Lori though. Hey, I lost Lori. Hey, John, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good.
We lost Lori. Hey, John, listen. Lori just got jammed again. So why don't you just go ahead and take over?
Okay. Well, that was a powerful message there from Carol Bundy. I tell you what, I think the world of that family. I've been involved here for the last couple of years, watching what's going on in these court systems. And right now I'm here on the ground here in Las Vegas, Nevada. And we've been in the middle of this second retrial for these four defendants here in the Bundy trial. And we're at the end of it now, as you just heard what Miss Bundy said there about the jurors are deliberating. I tell you what, it's been the last 5 weeks have been something else, witnessing what's going on in this court. We listened to 4.5 weeks of the prosecution here and bring witnesses after witnesses again, so-called professional witnesses, all employees of the BLM or the FBI, different branches of the alphabet agencies. Not one single civilian ever testified. And when we got to the end of this trial, we watched a great travesty happen here, where the judge and the prosecutors, and it's hard to believe this, but they refused to let any witnesses come forth to testify on the behalf of these defendants. She said the judge made a ruling that you do not have a right to defend yourself in the case of whether there's law enforcement involved. So if there's any law enforcement trying to arrest you, even if it's they're arresting you without a warrant, illegally or whatever, breaking into your house, you do not have a right to defend yourself. And she said that followed into the courtroom, and that she would not allow them to have a defense here. We watched multiple witnesses being turned away that came to testify on the behalf of these defendants. And it left just the defendants themselves here to testify in the last few days. And Eric Parker got up on the stand, one of the defendants, and the judge literally struck his testimony and did not allow him to testify on his own behalf because she did not like what he had to say. Finally, we did get one defendant, Scott Drexler, one of the four defendants, and he testified for a short hour or so, very carefully. He had to really pick his words to testify because so much stuff was not allowed. Nothing about the snipers that the BLM had could be entered into the evidence. Nothing about BLM agents pointing guns at protesters. All of this stuff was stricken from the ears of the jurors. We rested this case. We didn't even get to rest this case. These defendants did not even get to do a closing argument as they normally would, because the judge and the prosecutor wanted to read over their closing argument before they rested. So these defendants did not even rest, and they did not do any closing arguments before the judge just quickly turned it over to the jurors to start deliberating. And that was last week. So the jurors started deliberating on Tuesday evening. They've been deliberating on Thursday and Friday, and then they started deliberating again today. And we've seen, I feel like, a big miracle in this case. The jurors, it looks and appears to us that they're seeing through this. And one or two or multiple of the jurors wrote a note to the judge today. And that note was calling out two other jurors. And these other jurors were saying, these two jurors, juror number 6 and juror number 9, they say that they are biased and they're not deliberating properly. They're not going through the deliberation process with the rest of the jurors. And they were called up today, and we had them brought up into the courtroom to question those two jurors. And the judge and the prosecutor decided that those two jurors could do their job and were not biased against the government. They may be biased against the defendants, but not against the government. So they chose to go ahead and keep those two jurors, even if they're not getting along with the other 10 jurors. They decided to keep them and continue to keep them. And that's where we ended off the day.
So, John.
Yes.
With that, And you were going over the situation so that everybody can understand what's going on with the verdict watch, and you do such an amazing job. I want to thank you and Andrea and everybody who's out there doing that to keep us informed of the truth of what's going on. Tell the audience just how powerful the day with the closing arguments when they stood up, because what the audience needs to know is just how historical this is. This is unheard of, what really happened. And so that maybe they can picture how that happened in the courtroom.
it was literally shocking to all of us in the courtroom. There was other attorneys there, and you know, the jurors are expecting these defendants' attorneys to stand up and give a closing argument. What the jurors did not know is that these closing arguments were going to be micromanaged by the prosecution and the judge, that they were telling them what they could say. So these defendants and their attorneys decided unanimously to not give a closing argument. And that was very powerful. Each defendant's attorney stood up and said, in their exact words, says, "Your Honor, Stephen Sturrett does not have a closing argument at this time." And then the next one stood up, "Your Honor, Eric Parker does not have a closing argument at this time." All four of these attorneys for the defense team stood up and they said that. They did not rest. They stated, because of what they were being, the pressure they were being put on, that at this time, that's the big words there, that they did not have a closing argument. And they had reasons for that. The judge just overlooked it. She was so upset, aggravated, that she turned almost immediately and turned the case over to the jurors, and she rested the case without these defendants resting. They never even got to say that they rested and they had no more to say. Then she got up and she walked off the bench.
Wow. And on that note,
unbelievable.
We're coming
hang
up
tight.
On break.
Hang tight. Yeah, everybody hold tight. We're going to be right back after this break. This is Eric, Lori, John, Gary, and all of you out there. We appreciate this. Boy, is the deck stacked against the people or what? And we got a lot of good galls on other networks talking about the war in Afghanistan and all this other crap. The war is here. We'll be right back after this break.
Corporate media dominates the American opinion. Finding independent voices that counter this avalanche is becoming increasingly difficult. With the endless corruption running rampant throughout our government, independent voices are needed more than ever to battle the offensive against our freedoms and liberties. As a listener of RBN, no one understands this concept better than you. Now it's up to you to do your part. The time has come for you to take action and begin broadcasting the truth to hundreds or thousands of people every month. Sound impossible? Quite the contrary. With pointed slogans from LibertyStickers.com, you can reach countless sleeping Americans unaware that they live in a real-life wonderland. LibertyStickers.com has a huge inventory of political bumper stickers and messages that reflect the truth about our government, our politicians, and the future of America. With so many in stock, there's one perfect for you. Visit us today at LibertyStickers.com. Again, that's LibertyStickers.com. Do your part. Your voice is important. Let it be heard.
Folks, we're living in a world the likes of which we've never perceived any clearer than we do now. The plan for global governance has been in the works for generations and would have likely been achieved by now but for the fact that the globalists left open their Achilles heel. With all their tools, Federal Reserve System, fiat currency, No Child Left Behind, and then Common Core education introduced to our schools to dumb us down, vaccines, pharmaceuticals to lobotomize us, GMO foods, insertion of compromised or bought and paid for politicians, judges, mainstream media propaganda, all pieced together like a puzzle designed to ultimately bring the world under submission. But with all their strategy, they forgot one thing: knowledge. And knowledge is power. With knowledge, their bombardment is nullified. Folks, with that, as brilliant and knowledgeable as you've become, among the wisest audience of any radio audience in the world, and you are, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, how much of that knowledge did I obtain from Republic Broadcasting Network? How high has my consciousness been raised since I've been a listener? How fast am I now able to discriminate truth from fake news by being a Republic Broadcasting listener? How clear am I now able to see the world since I've been listening to RBN? Ask yourselves those questions, folks. Then ask yourself, what is that knowledge worth to me? Like my morning coffee, how would I survive without it? A voice of truth in a sea of lies. Do we not all need to make sure it survives? Like public broadcasting, we are now finding we can only survive with listener support. Censorship, advertisers being attacked, truth itself being attacked. It's the only way through this. We at Republic Broadcasting humbly ask you to become a supporter. Look at your budget and make a determination of what Republic Broadcasting is worth to you and what you can afford on a monthly basis. Go to republicbroadcasting.org and pledge 20, 30, 40, 50, if possible, 100 a month or more if it's affordable. Click the donate button and become a regular monthly donor. Assure both us and yourself that Republic Broadcasting Truth will continue to flow like that morning coffee. The network thanks you.
My friend, welcome to the broadcast. Thanks for joining us live on this Monday. The war is here. You want to know where the front lines of the battle is? It's in Nevada. Right now. That's where the war is. There's no war in Afghanistan. That's a giant ripoff. That's, you know what that is? Those are pirates and thieves wearing the army man uniform, which now, disgustingly, is all black with gold bars on the top like the Nazis wore. Just like in World War II. What happened to the old green uniform dress, even the formal? I mean, it's gross. We have a bunch of pirates and thieves and killers all running around the world. Anything they can do to take your eyes off Nevada. Anything they can do to take your eyes off the persecution of the patriots. The great patriot persecution of 2017 is rolling forward like the Wehrmacht. And so is the United States military overseas, trying to distract the people at home from the atrocities being committed at home. Doesn't sound like much like can happen in Germany, does it, huh? While the troop, oh, look over there. We're invading Poland and Spain and AFRICOM and Afghanistan and Iran and everything, Syria and Yemen. Great. And distract all the people from what's really going on here. Atrocities are being committed in Nevada. Go, Lori, take over.
And, you know, people need to understand this trial, whether you do or do not support the Bundys or what happened in 2014 or Oregon is irrelevant. You should support what is going on by getting this message out. Let me tell you why. Your First Amendment guarantee, your Second Amendment guarantee, your Fourth Amendment guarantee, your Fifth Amendment guarantee, your Sixth Amendment guarantee, your Eighth Amendment, your Tenth Amendment, and your Ninth Amendment are all being attacked in this case. It does not matter whether you agree or disagree with what went on or not. The fact of the matter is, if we allow it to happen to one individual, then it
will let it happen to everybody.
You.
Absolutely. This is coming for all of us. It's coming for all of us, everybody. This is why the woeful silence, the compliance by acquiescence from this entire administration, it's going to come back on their hands. They're going to get exactly what they deserve, and it ain't going to be pretty.
Right. So, John, are you willing to stay on the line for a few minutes? We do have a caller, and I don't know if the caller might have a question for you.
Yes, I can stay on the line.
Okay, thank you very much. Chance, how are you doing tonight?
Yes, hello, folks. You're 100% right. This case is a travesty of justice. It's very bizarre. And this judge is bizarre. I can't understand why they don't remove her from the bench, I'll be honest with you.
Well, in an Obama appointment helped put in by Harry Reid, one of the most corrupt politicians in the United States of America that's breathing today, that loves stealing the land masses from the people to support his private family venues, has a lot to do with it. And, you know, a lot of us, Eric can also say this, you know, I've never believed that any solution comes out of Washington, D.C. I've never believed in the new president is the savior type thing. However, I do believe in giving benefit of the doubt.
Well, and, like you said previously, this is going to affect everybody in the country.
Yes,
they should be concerned about this case. But I've been following this in the alternative press, and I have one question.
Sure.
I understand they concerning this one defendant, Gregory Burleson.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I believe he got 68-year sentence, correct?
Yes, he did.
Okay. Now, my question is this, and I might be a little confused on this, and maybe one of you can clear this up. But I also read he was an FBI informant. Now,
yep.
Correct.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yes. The FBI do eat their own, and they will use you up until they can use you no more, and then they throw you under the bus. And this is what we try to get people to understand. You are not protected just because you think you're working for that three-letter agency to set up real American people. And if you'll hold, we'll finish answering your question right after this break.
Sure, thank you.
You are tuned in to the Republic Broadcasting Network. Visit our website by going to republicbroadcasting.org.
It's time for you to have your own custom smartphone app for your business and pay way less than you can imagine. Introducing the I Can Get To Silent Salesman mobile marketing app, a global mobile marketing and communication tool for your business. Go to appsapart.com and learn how you could earn up to $36,351 or more per month just by inviting two people or less into a $14.95 per month program. Go to appsapart.com and be sure to watch the video at the top of the site and listen to the audio message from the CEO near the bottom. This is something you won't want to miss. Go to appsapart.com now or call 646-860-9540. That's 646-860-9540. Get the I Can Get To. That's ICANGET, the number 2, Silent Salesman app at appsapart.com. That's appsapart.com. It's time for you to have your own custom smartphone app for your business and pay way less than you can imagine. Introducing the I Can Get To Silent Salesman mobile marketing app, a global mobile marketing and communication tool for your business. Go to appsapart.com and learn how you could earn up to $36,351 or more per month just by inviting two people or less into a $14.95 per month program. Go to appsapart.com and be sure to watch the video at the top of the site and listen to the audio message from the CEO near the bottom. This is something you won't want to miss. Go to appsapart.com now or call 646-860-9540. That's 646-860-9540. Get the I Can Get To. That's ICANGET, the number 2, Silent Salesman app at appsapart.com. That's appsapart.com.
You've probably heard about all the great benefits of goat milk soap. But did you know? Some companies take shortcuts. At Old New England Soap, we make our organic goat's milk soap using 36% goat's milk. That's 17% more than most others. Our bars are larger, so they last longer, producing lots of lather packed with vitamins. And our soap is a natural moisturizer that smooths dry and damaged skin. Order online at oldnesoap.com. That's oldnesoap.com. You've tried the rest. Now try the best. Oldnesoap.com.
Water-based soaps on supermarket shelves use harsh chemical acids to break down dead skin cells. And that's just not good for you. At Old New England Soap, our soaps are made without chemical ingredients, contain no alcohol or petroleum products, and use 85% organic materials and carry the USDA's organic certification. Try some today. Go to oldnesoap.com. That's oldnesoap.com. Oldnesoap.com.
Without the right accessories, any guy can be off the mark. Whether you've invested thousands in your arsenal or you own a single trusted firearm, a visit to AROutfitting.com is in order. It's one of the finest online selections of tactical optics and AR parts and add-ons, like EOTech, quick target acquisition with no peripheral loss. Browse the full range of Nikon scopes and binoculars. AROutfitting.com can illuminate your world with Streamlight gun-mounted lights from keychain to large handhelds up to 1,100 lumens. Find some stability with Battenfield tactical bipods. AirOutfitting.com has CMMG gun parts, barrels, assemblies, handguards, part kits, and more. Plus Magpul clips and magazines. I know I've got you excited. So take a breath, head to aroutfitting.com. The site's super easy to navigate and features a ton of technical info, including links to manuals. We also welcome vendor and manufacturer inquiries. Remember, if you don't see it, we can get it at aroutfitting.com.
Upset you out. Don't you know everything's all right? Yes, everything's fine. And we want you to sleep well tonight. Let the world turn without you tonight. If we try, we'll get by, so forget all about us tonight.
Everything's all right. Yes, everything's all right. Yes.
Sleep and I shall soothe you, calm you, and anoint you, melt all your hot forehead out. Then you feel everything's alright, yes, everything's fine. And it's cool and the ointment sweet for the fire in your head and feet. Close your eyes and relax, think of nothing tonight.
Everything's alright, yes, everything's alright, yes.
Come on, to find ointment, brand new and expensive. Could that be said for the poor? Why has it been wasted? We could have raised maybe 300 silver pieces or more. People who are hungry, people who are starving, matter more than your feet and hands.
Try not to get worried, try not to turn on to problems that upset you. Don't you know everything's alright? Yes, everything's fine. And we want you to sleep well tonight. Let the world turn without you tonight. If we try, we'll get by, so forget.
To save the poor from their lot, there will be more always pathetically struggling. Look at the good things you've got. Think while you still have me. Move while you still see me. You'll be lost. You'll be so, so lonely when I'm gone.
Welcome back, my friends. Welcome back to the broadcast. Soundtrack to Jesus Christ Superstar from 1970. Ian Gillan from Deep Purple playing Jesus Christ, and Yvonne Ellman as Mary Magdalene. Great song, great voices. Anyway, we are blessed to have John Lamb, Laurie Anderson, hopefully Gary in Michigan, who's kicking back in the wings. Gary, we'll probably get to you in a little bit. But we're giving some time to John right now because this is the most important thing going on in the world right now. I don't care. Forget the country. Anywhere. This is it. If we sink, the whole rest of the world sinks with us. If the freedom doesn't float here, it's not going to fly anywhere. It's got to be here. We got to get our own ship in order. We got to get our own house in order. And there's no such thing as America right or wrong. If America's wrong, we better right the ship or we're going to sink. And the ship is sinking fast right now. We're all the way down to tyranny. The lifeboats are sinking. I mean, this is bad. What's going on in Nevada with this judge is absolutely disgusting. And with just before I get off on getting too angry, I'm going to turn it right back over to Laurie and John. Thanks for being with us tonight on Freedom Scream with Eric the Freedom Screamer. Laurie Anderson?
Yes, hi. So I was talking, Chance had a question. He was talking about Greg Burleson. And so you were correct, Chance. Greg Burleson was an FBI informant. And, yes, they did throw him under the bus. And, yes, he did get much more than what he should have gotten originally. John, correct me if I'm wrong, but originally the defense basically was that he was doing what they wanted him to do. And so he was trying to use that as a defense. And, of course, that backfired. Is that correct, John?
I think that's correct, if I understood you right, yes.
Okay.
Okay, and so my question is this, though. I know they eat their own. I realize that. There is no honor among thieves. But my question is, aren't they wary of, since he served them in some capacity previously, aren't they worried that by giving him such a harsh sentence that he could blow the lid off this whole thing in the future? That's just one thing that puzzles me. I don't know if it's a naive question, but that's what I tend to feel.
The witches are stupid.
I could probably answer a little bit of that if you want me to. I make a lot of interviews and visits into the jails visiting these guys, and I have visited Greg Burleson many times. Greg Burleson came to the refuge there, or not to the refuge, I'm sorry, to the Bundy Ranch when they was having that big protest in 2014, pretty much for one day. He didn't know Clive and Bundy. He didn't know anybody. We don't know exactly his intentions there, but he got 68 years because he would not turn later on. He had started working for the FBI back in 2012, and he was working in Arizona.
It wasn't related to this particular situation.
It was not under this, but it was other cases, and he had a couple of different FBI handlers for a couple of years working other cases. What he ended up doing is he refused to turn and give any information that he knew on the Bundys, is what information I'm gathering, and they threw the book at him because he refused to turn.
Yeah. Well, that's the only thing about this case that confused me, be honest with you. I see the tragedy. This judge is so bizarre from what I've been reading. I can't understand how she's even a judge. I mean,
she's a psychopath.
Exactly. It's astounding. But that's the only thing that I'm trying to clear up. There's this one particular defendant here, and I don't know. I just don't know what to think about it. And this is why I asked your opinion regarding this particular defendant.
Now, this is the very first handful of defendants, so there's been six all told that's been tried. There's six of them in the very first trial, which two of them had found guilty of some charges. Four of them, it was a mistrial, and they retried those four guys again this time. We do know that there are other informants that are involved in this case that they haven't brought forward yet. That are confidential human sources, yes. We do know it. We can't talk about it right now because it hasn't been brought out in court. So know there's others that are definitely involved. Like in Oregon, there were 15 that were outed out before it was over with. So
that's all?
The refuge guilt, yes, 15 just in Oregon, not counting this over here. We know there some of the same informants were working at the Bundy Ranch. Like Will Coleman is one name that I can say publicly. He was at the Bundy Ranch, and he was also at the refuge. So he worked both places. And and then the FBI, this case here, the FBI had a fake news group called Longbow. And Longbow has been brought out, and Longbow went in acting like they were a news media outlet, and they tricked, pretty much probably almost every 19 of these defendants into giving an interview at one point or another, and multiple other people that's never been indicted yet. Mm-hmm. And their whole case was built out of Longbow and Facebook. This is this whole case, that's what it's built out of.
Yeah, wow. Well, let's all keep the Bundys in our prayers.
Absolutely.
Like you said, like I said, I've been following it. I was only confused about that one particular defendant. That's the reason why I called, to be honest with you. Okay, folks, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Let me just pick up real quick before you get back to your thought. I just wanted to grab up on something John just said. 15 occupiers at the refuge in Oregon
we're a federal agency. That's 50. There's only 30 people or something there. That's 50% of the the people up in Burns, Oregon, were agent provocateurs. So when I hear other hosts saying agent provocateurs are very rare, agent provocateurs, oh, that does, they almost don't exist. It's like a, it's like finding a needle in a haystack. Baloney. 50% of them were, there were 50% is rare. Oh, please.
Wow. That's incredible. Now, that's news to me. That I haven't read, and that's pretty shocking.
Now, there was, there was 27 defendants and 15 informants.
That's over 50%.
Think of the numbers there. Yes.
Wow.
And the FBI has been getting by with setting up quote-unquote crimes of quote-unquote terrorism and, you know, things like that. For years, they've been setting people up and been caught doing it, and then the people still get charged with that.
Well, and that they, they had the Bundys in their crosshairs, apparently,
because of the land.
Let's pray for the Bundys. All right, folks, good night now.
Good night. And, you know, guys, I want to say this. To Eric and John, and thank you, Chance, for calling in. We really did enjoy that that call. But this is what it reminds me of. And will ye pollute me among my people for handfuls of barley and for pieces of bread, to slay the souls that should not die, and to save the souls alive that should not live, by your lying to my people that hear your lies? Wherefore, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I am against your pillows, wherewith ye there hunt the souls to make them fly, and I will tear them from your arms, and will let the souls go, even the souls that ye hunt to make them fly. Your kerchiefs also will I tear, and deliver my people out of your hand, and they shall be no more in your hand to be hunted, and ye shall know that I am the Lord, because with lies ye have made the heart of the righteous sad, whom I have not made sad, and strengthened the hands of the wicked, that he should not return from his wicked way, by promising him life. Therefore ye shall see no more vanity nor divine divinations, for I will deliver my people out of your hand, and ye shall know that I am the Lord.
Beautiful.
And that reminds me of that, the topic of Greg. We agree that what Greg got was really, truly not, quote unquote, justice. It really was not. What they have done to him is also wrong. What he did to the people was also wrong. But that doesn't mean that we should go along with and agree with what the feds have done to him. So we need to remember that. We need to also keep him in our prayers. And with that being said, John, do you have anything you would like to add?
I just wanted to say two wrongs don't make a right, but dealing with the devil like this guy did with the FBI and then trying to go get his conscience right and do it, once you get in with them, you don't leave. And that's why John said, you know, they threw the book at him because he didn't continue to play ball with the FBI. Maybe he had a change of heart. Maybe he didn't. But, John, you comment on that. Go ahead, John.
Yeah, one thing I noticed in this case, and, you know, being an observer, I don't comment much on this kind of stuff just because it's hard to do because I'm trying to talk to these different people. But some of these people have not been principled. Right. And that's a big difference. Their own actions, their own words have gotten them in trouble in these cases. Mm-hmm. And we're seeing that with different individuals, and that's sad. So the Bundys themselves, everything that I have watched videos, and like LaVoy Finicum, these men are upstanding men. They have only one thing in mind, and that's the freedom of their children and grandchildren and every American. And they're fighting a fight that is a godly fight and an uprighteous fight. And so that's what we found out in Oregon. When Ammon testified on the stand, he testified for 3.5 days. And Mumford fought hard to get his testimony out. Ammon did not waver. He didn't lie on the under oath. The government was speechless when he got done with 3.5 days of testimony. And that's the kind of fight we're fighting, is these type of things. And when you get unprincipled people that get involved, they have other agendas and other problems, and these, you know, working with the government informants, and this is what happens. They get locked up, and it's a sad thing, because I don't feel like Greg Burleson did anything to get 68 years in prison. He's a blind guy. He's already suffering, but they made sure that they're going to make him suffer and make a statement out of him, so anybody else that's working for them, it definitely doesn't turn on them, you know, on the government.
Well, they also need to realize and take this message. Instead of the turning idea, they need to realize when you make a deal with the devil, or you go knocking on the devil's door long enough, he's going to answer. And when you put yourself in a snake pit of vipers, expect to get bitten.
Exactly right.
You know, and that's what happens. A lot of these people are tricked into being CIs, or otherwise known as confidential informants, or instigators, or whatever the case may be. And they're under this illusion, well, because I'm doing this for the FBI, or because I'm doing this for another three-letter or four-letter alphabet agency, I'm going to be protected. I'm 10 foot tall. I'm bulletproof. There's no way they'll ever arrest me because I'm doing what they want me to do. And then the reality sets in. You know, I believe, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I know it was either Hitler or Stalin, but I'm pretty sure it was Hitler. Once he got in as leader, he then annihilated his top men. And he did that. Why? Because they're the only ones who would know strategically how to get him out. So it's really sad. But, you know, that's for anybody out there who is thinking about being a CI, who is thinking that you can trust these alphabet agencies. You know, just dig into the details. Why would you work for a crime syndicate? You know, I have previously contacted senator when there was a quote-unquote new gun law coming up. This was a couple of years ago, and I honestly asked the senator's office a legitimate question, told them do not support that, and it was about the ATF coming and trying to approve or disapprove people for their background checks. And I'll tell you what happened in that conversation on the after the next break.
Beautiful. We got Lori, we got Gary, we got John, we got blessings tonight, we got information, real deal here. The battle's in Vegas. It's in Nevada, right outside Sin City. We'll be right back after this break.
Homeowners, if your lender has gone out of business or sold your transaction to another lender or servicer, you may be the victim of a wrongful foreclosure resulting in the loss of your home. If you've already lost your home, are in foreclosure, or even in good standing, you can challenge the mortgage transaction's illegal issue and your property can be restored to you, and your foreclosure can be stopped or reversed and the mortgage transaction declared unenforceable. State laws, U.S. title codes, the Uniform Commercial Codes, and U.S. Supreme Court rulings have upheld that defective mortgage documentations can reverse or stop foreclosures and enforce property title claims in favor of the homeowner. We are having successes in stopping the process of foreclosure, the enforcement of the foreclosure judgments, the sale of property, and evictions after the sale. We are not attorneys, and we don't give legal advice. We are a professional team of legal researchers, providing forensic mortgage audits and expert witnesses. We have the knowledge to produce the evidence and enforce laws regarding your legal issues. We've been in business for 12 years without a complaint. Consultations are free, and we provide a free title search to confirm if your mortgage has legal defects. Please call 855-253-3748. 855-2-KEEP-IT today.
Okay, nurse, let's get this man to the ER, stat.
Right away, doctor.
We see this every day. Heart attack or angina pain due to blocked and clogged arteries. Chelation can remove obstructions or blockages from arteries and help avoid painful and expensive surgery. Now there's Angioprim. It's a liquid oral chelation product that you take with juice. You start to feel the results fast. Angioprim increases blood flow all over the body, and that means more energy and strength to take on the day with less aches and pains. 60 years of research has gone into chelation, and Angioprim is the result. A safe and easy way to unblock your veins and arteries from buildup that slow circulation.
Paging Dr. Jones, please report to the emergency room right away.
Log on now for a special radio offer from Angioprim. That's angioprim.com/radio. A-N-G-I-O-P-R-I-M. Angioprim.com/radio or call 877-882-7221. That's 877-882-7221.
Do you or someone you know suffer from chest pain, blood pressure, cholesterol, or irregular heartbeat? Are you looking for a more natural solution to overcome these health challenges? You hear the ads all the time. If this stuff's so good, why doesn't my doctor prescribe it? That's easy. Doctors are not trained in natural medicine. Extendivite Heart Tonic does want you to be as healthy as you can be, and it really works. Take Extendivite for 6 months and your doctor will say, I don't know what you're doing, but don't stop. It's working for you. Get the dependability of Extendivite. Just see how you feel in 6 months. A 2 month supply of either capsules or liquid is only $69.95 plus shipping and handling. Call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Welcome back, my friends. Welcome back to the broadcast. It's Eric, the Freedom Screamer on the Republic Broadcasting Network. Thank you all for joining us tonight. We appreciate you all being here. I guess if you're listening to this, you have some desire to hear a little more pertinent news, truth, than you're going to get somewhere else. I mean, I went to heard it again today. They're all pimping Afghanistan, and Trump's going to do this and that, and it's horrible, blah, 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 blah. It's like they're doing everybody else in the media is doing anything they can, and I'm not talking about this network, I'm talking about their networks, but similar to this one, do anything they can to keep from talking about this issue. This is the most important thing going on right now. The Republic's they watched the witch's court. It very specifically, all around the country, believe me, coast to coast. So it's indisputable, and this has been going on since it's gotten worse. Since Donald Trump became president, I wish I didn't have to report that. I want to love Donald Trump. I want to think we got a good libertarian, a good constitutionalist, some kind of conservative. Is war conservative? Of course not. War is communistic and fascistic. It's a thing of the socialist, progressive left. It's not of, and they got everybody thinking the war is conservative, the drug war, man, a good conservative got to go after those drugs, and a good conservative, and we got to go fight those enemies. It's all baloney. Y'all pseudo-conservatives have been fooled into thinking war is conservative, and now you're nothing more than communists and drag. So, John Lamb, back to you, my friend. John and Lori Anderson tonight, and we're going to turn it right back over to you guys to get back on point here with the atrocities that are being committed by Judge Navarro. What is her first name, Gloria?
Yes.
Yes. Gloria Navarro seems to be, I mean, and it doesn't seem to be. I mean, we've been here months watching this woman. She's a psychopathic maniac. She's a killer who would be knifing people if she could get away with it. But she lives in the modern society, so she goes through the bar exam, and she legalizes her witchery, and now she tortures the Bundy and people like Tom LaCavara. Interesting women. And Gloria Navarro, the Bundys. Over in LaCavara's case, it's Judge Anna Brown. Mm-hmm. In Chris Kay's case, it was Jennifer Togliatti and Nancy Becker.
Mm-hmm.
We're seeing a pattern here.
All across the union, union, it absolutely is. John, is there anything else that you? Oh, yes, John, do tell about the protest that about the quote unquote jail cell that the protest in front of the jail, and they tried
Camp
to force
Liberty.
Y'all to take it down.
Yes, I've got a couple things I can tell you about that. One other thing too, but yeah, we had a jail cell. We had what we called Camp Liberty here a couple of months ago out of the prison. And we brought that jail cell into the courthouse to set it up as a demonstration. We even tried to make sure we wasn't going to cause trouble by having it there. So we talked to the Homeland Security people before we brought it. And we hadn't had it there more than an hour. And Metro PD came down and surrounded us. they was even, like, in formation, backing up when they was leaving, acting like we was really scary people. But they ordered us to remove it, and they stayed there until we had the thing packed up and hauled away. I have built a new one, and I finished it up over the weekend, and we took it back there. And this one here is made out of pipes, like plumbing pipes, instead of plywood and lumber, PVC pipes. So we had it there all day today, and so far we haven't had no problems with this new one. One thing I did want to bring up...
Yeah, hang on. Can you wait? Can you hang on for one more segment, John, at least? John, hold there. We're going to get back to you right after this break, John. I want to finish up with you. You know, I want you to have some more time, so hold right there. If you've got the time, I want to talk to you after the top of the hour some more. Thank you for being with us, John. Yeah. Stay where you are. Lori, we're going to be right back. We want to hear more from John. As much as possible, you got the whole hour if he wants it, and I'll plug his stuff, too. We'll be right back after the top of this hour. This is Eric, the Freedom Screamer on the RBN Network with John Lamb, Lori Anderson, and Gary Hyden in the background. I know he's there. We always love his support, and we're going to have a prayer from him after this break. We'll be right back.
Without the right accessories...
Welcome back, my friends. Welcome back. This is Eric, the Freedom Screamer. We're going to give Eric Clapton a little less time right there because we got John Lamb on the phone, and we want to respect John's time. John, we got a full hour. You can take as much of that as you want. This is John Lamb, L-A-M-B as in boy, John Lamb. And if you go online, you type in Bundy Updates or John Lamb, you'll get his stuff. He's the tall guy with the beard, and he's doing a fantastic job there with Andrea Parker. They're kind of the two main people reporting on the scene. In absence of Tom LaCavara and Pete Santulli and other people who have gotten locked up recently. So we really value having John there, you know, picking up the torch and running with it. You know, it would be like if Lyndon B. Johnson turned out to be Kennedy, just like Kennedy was, the New World Order would have no chance if the next person in line just kept doing what the person before them did, which is push the freedom and nobody gets scared and runs from the battle. John does not run from the battle. He runs to the battle as the Lord delegated us to run to the battle. Storm the gates of hell, come what may. The victory is God's. We're delegated to fight it, though, not give up, not sit around waiting for the second coming. We need to be busy while that's coming down the pike soon in the near future, hopefully. But meanwhile, Psalms 94:16, who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity? John is right there on the scene doing that. John, I'm going to get the one quick question, turn it right back over to you and Lori. I was just curious why your first prop, the jail that you had, well, it made you take it down, but the one you're going to go back with is okay. Is it a difference in material that you're using?
Yeah, the lumber one, they're calling it a permanent structure because it's made out of 2x4s and plywood. So,
too heavy duty for them.
It's just technicality of code that they're going by. So I decided to try to invent something differently, and I used PVC pipe this time.
Good job.
Right, a little more light duty. Yeah, they love their Chinese junk. Yeah, something a little more light duty that'll break a little easier if they want to break heads. I got you. All right, So you got your prop in there, though. You talk about persistence. Oh, beautiful. That's great. Okay, so you got that there. That helps make the point. Now, John, one last little thing before I turn it over to you and Lori. I'd like to see you take a $20 bill, go out, get yourself a T-shirt that says jury nullification on it, and wear it in all those videos because that's valuable time to me that's being –
in my mind, you know, me with the jury nullification, I think if you could wear that shirt a little more often that says jury nullification, and then some people out there who are surfing YouTube and see you are going to want to know what that is as well. Just a little plug for jury nullification. Try to get a sign in every one of your videos, like right between you and Andrea, just between your heads over to the back, jury nullification. Get in every frame of video that you can, because that one person who gets it, you know what happens, and we get freedom.
Yes, exactly. I'll try to have one on tomorrow. I actually have a new shirt that came in, so I will try to do that tomorrow. That's a good point.
Beautiful.
Awesome. So go ahead with what happened with this makeshift jail cell, and it's pretty interesting that you said that they were backing up as if they were almost afraid. You know, I just want to say this before you finish. If you are a police officer listening, whether you're a police officer or whether you're a sheriff, because we know we have many of you listening, if you are afraid of a structure, or you are afraid or so afraid that you have to have, let's say, 15 officers to talk to one or two people, you may be in the wrong line of service. You may not be in the right job venue, because you need to be able to not fear everybody that you speak with. Because when you are to a point of acting as if you're fearful, unless you have 15 to 30 officers with you to speak with three people, then that means, you know, you might need to get a little bit of an evaluation going on, because you might have a phobia.
I just got the greatest idea. I think they should take some diapers and present them to the police officers as a peace officer offering, kind of like the hippies used to do in the 60s with sticking the rose in the end barrel of the gun. Well, hang a little diaper on there, pink ones with a little rose on it that says, here you go, guys. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, you know, it's just, it's to the point. And I know, because I've read a lot of the documents, I know how they're trained. They're taught fear, 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 you know, shoot first, ask questions later, fear, fear, fear. You know, the American people are the enemy, fear, 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 and this, that, and the other. But the reality is, if you are really that fearful of people, you need to go and get some mental help, because you certainly don't need to be in any type of situation where you're supposed to be serving the people and where you're supposed to be able to speak to people on a daily basis.
Seriously.
And it's sad. It's almost as if, you know, if I'm walking down the street and I see people, you know, I'm not going to, oh, well, I need 50 people around me to be able to talk to you, because you might hurt me because you have a cell phone, or you might hurt me because you have a sidearm on you, or you might hurt me because you have a knife on me. No, then that means you're not real confident in your training either. Because if you are trained and you're truly in the right mental capacity, most people will respect you as you show respect to other people. Now, John, let's get back to that, because we'll get sidetracked on that, and I'll just keep rambling on to the listeners.
Okay.
I want them to hear about this jail cell, because I think this is phenomenal, and what you all are doing out there is amazing. I really wish I could join you. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to, but let them know what happened with the jail cell.
Well, they really are intimidated by it. We tried to make it look as real as we could. We have real handcuffs, so whoever gets inside of this jail cell, we actually handcuff them up just like you would if you got arrested. And we have signs all around this jail cell talking about jury nullification, talking about unlawful arrest, talking about Eric Parker and these defendants being gagged in the courtroom, not being able to speak for their own defense. And we didn't even have it up an hour on last week on Thursday before we were literally surrounded in kind of a scary confrontation, because these guys literally have their hands on their guns. Mm-hmm. We're on supposedly federal property, so, you know, we're all unarmed. We're just a handful of peaceful protesters down there waiting on a verdict. And they literally surround us and intimidate us and tell us that it's a structure that's violating codes, building codes and stuff, and we have to remove the thing off of public property. So we did. We complied, and we hauled it away. But today we came back with even a better one, because this one here is, it still replicates a gel cell. It gets the point about, but it's made out of some cheap plastic that it shouldn't intimidate or violate any building codes. It might build, I'm not a good plumber, so it may violate some plumbing codes or something.
or delicate sensibilities, maybe. Delicate sensibilities, maybe. that political correctness is pretty amusing. But what they're doing out in Las Vegas, Nevada, at the federal courthouse, they are now on verdict watch, and which means the jury is deliberating. They have, just to recap a little bit, if you just joined us, there have been jury questions coming out there about possible bias within the jury pool itself. And I also remember, if I'm remembering correctly, John, you need to confirm or deny this, because I want to make sure I'm stating this correctly. I don't know if this was, I believe this was on Thursday. There was also a jury question, and the jury question was about, they wanted to know why that audio was allowed in certain cases when the federal government put it there to be able to hear what the Patriots said, but cut out everything that the BLM or the officers or anything else said in those statements, and that was questioned by the jury. Is that correct?
That is correct. I'm glad you brought that up, because the first trial, we was allowed to have the videos with audio. This time, the government did not like what this audio said in the videos. It's government exhibits. So this ain't defense exhibits. This is government exhibits that have been entered into evidence, but they redacted the audio part out of it because they think the jurors may go with jury nullification on it. So the jurors got all this video evidence now that has no audio. Mm-hmm. And that was the question they asked, is why is there no audio with all these videos? They can't tell what's being said. And they're going by a video, and there's obviously somebody saying something, but they can't hear it. And that's, the judge refused to answer it. She won't tell them why. They don't need to know what's in there, is what she told them.
What a scammer.
Does that go to the statement, and correct the statement if I misquote it, but does that go to the statement of we shoot first and ask questions later?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That would be probably a little bit discriminating on the government's case. And if I'm not mistaken, they were also laughing about picking out individuals in the crowd, men, women, and children, that they were going to shoot first. Is that correct?
Yes, that is exactly what was being said in there. They said they were talking in these videos like, well, the BLM officers would say, there's a fat one. There is a woman and she's fat. Maybe take her out first. She's probably not married. That was the kind of stuff that was in this video that they do not want the jurors to hear, of how the misconduct of these officers were during that time and how they were making fun of different protesters out there.
Right.
Misconduct. Right. You're lunatics.
Right.
Yes.
Now, I want to say one this. Thing. Go ahead.
One thing that was interesting today, and we kind of joked about it, but the electricity went out in the courthouse. So the electric is working all around the whole block of downtown Las Vegas, but the courthouse doesn't have any electricity. So the jurors, for about 3 hours this morning, they couldn't even watch the video. So then they had videos that they couldn't watch that didn't have audio either. So they was kind of at a loss this morning.
I have a question, because this has arisen in the previous trial as well, so I'm not sure if I'm correct on this, but I'm pretty sure I am. Mr. Daniel P. Love was the complaining official, and I do that in quotes, everyone, if I'm not mistaken, and he has never been allowed to be put on the stand. Is that right?
He never has. His name barely got brought up in this trial. They tried to hide his name as much as possible, but they have kept him hidden. We have subpoenaed him, and they have denied it. They protect their own very closely, and they allow or want witnesses they want and do not allow us to have any witnesses at all.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know why they don't want him on the stand. They don't want him on the stand because he was found to be corrupt by another government organization that did a report on him. And that would all come out in the wash. But just saying that, I want the listeners to understand, in your Sixth Amendment, it says in all criminal prosecutions, the accused, not the prosecution, the accused. Let's reiterate that again. The accused shall enjoy the right to a speedy and public trial, which this has not been, by an impartial jury of the state and district wherein the crime shall have been committed, which district shall have been previously ascertained by law, and to be informed of the nature and cause of the accusation. Also, to be confronted with the witnesses against him. Daniel P. Love would be the number one because he was the one writing the complaint. To have compulsory process for obtaining witnesses in his favor, and to have the assistance of counsel for his defense, all of which is being denied in this situation. Now, your rights are unalienable rights. The Bill of Rights gives you nothing. Your unalienable rights you were born with from your first breath that you took, you had those rights, they were given to you by God, and they were confirmed in the Bill of Rights. And this
Daniel
is
P.
what
Love
we are
is the
allowing
one who did the
happen.
Indictment. Yep.
I know.
Daniel P. Love is the one that testified to the grand jury. He's the one that wrote the indictment with them. You know, it's mainly his testimony that started it all. And he testified to the grand jury. And they're keeping that witness away from the defense. The defense wants that witness before them. Mm-hmm. These defendants are begging for that defendant to be called forth, and they are refusing him.
Well, you know, this is something that I've questioned. This is something that I've questioned for this since the 2014 standoff. The individuals that were under Daniel P. Love's persuasion, or under his orders, if you will, however you want to say it, he had his men specifically, and I'm not talking about the snipers on the hill or the ones in the helicopters or the ones flying the drones or the ones in the MRAPs or the many ones that were really safely protected. I'm talking about the ones that were down in, I guess it's considered the wash. And he had them specifically and intentionally in a kill zone. If the protesters were anything like quote-unquote Antifa or BLM, those men would not be alive today, okay? It's only because they were peaceful protesters in the 2014 standoff at the ranch, and because it was people from all over the nation that were peaceful but took a stand. But to look at the video footage makes it look like he intentionally put his men in harm's way to make them targets in order to start a possible civil war. And you know,
Jack,
in 2015, I reported about Jade Helm 15. You remember when that was going on? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
I kept telling people, stop focusing on the actual physical drill. The main part of that you need to learn, you need to understand, and you need to really grasp is the mastering the human domain part. That is the most dangerous part of Jade Helm 15 because it is not over. It is known as the seventh warfighting function. It controls all of phone, social media, going into the cities, towns, and counties, befriending people and turning them to their ideology to make them go along with their plan. This is Department of Justice stuff. This is Rand Corporation stuff. This is what Jade Helm 15 was so dangerous, and it's not just the Jade Helm 15. It's the Mastering the Human Domain. And if you don't believe it, look up Mastering the Human Domain, Seventh Warfighting Function. I'm telling you, the documents are out there. We'll cover it on a different night. But it is definitely being used still today. It's being used by mainstream media. It's being used. Facebook is doing it in collusion with it. Google is doing it. Internet is doing it. And in these different quote-unquote movements, they are also doing it. It is all part of it. And they actually, when you read these documents, remember Operation Desert Storm? This is how, remember when they came and and they laid all their weapons at the Americans' feet over there. You remember that?
Yes.
That's how they did it. It was mastering the human domain. That's exactly what they did. So we need to really pay attention, because whether or not it's perceived or real, we have to be able to discern. We have to be able to fact check for ourselves. And Eric and I and John, we all say the same thing. Confirm it for yourself. Everything we say on this radio show, confirm it for yourself. We don't want you to take our word for it. We want you to dig. We want you to dig.
Yeah, just tell us, to one of these court hearings and set in the one of these court trials and hearings just for 1, 2, 3 days. I guarantee you, your eyes will be opened when you leave, and you'll see it differently. I hear it all the time from newcomers from all around the country that come and just listen to what's going on in these courts, and they are absolutely shocked. They're telling me that I'm not even telling it as bad as it is. They think I'm watering it down a little bit when they leave.
Right, right. Well, you're trying to report it, and I understand what you mean, because I do the same thing on a lot of things. But we do that because we don't want to overemphasize or make that mistake. We'll let the mainstream media make their mistakes, because when they find out, oh, we didn't even tell it as horrible as it was, you know, we were telling it, but this is some of the stuff you have to find out for yourself, people. You know, do some digging, research. We're out here for you. We're not out here to become famous. We're not out here to, you know, get our name on a billboard. We're not out here to try to tell you what, who, what, where, when, why, and how to think or what to do. We give you the information. We tell you where to look it up. We tell you how to find it. By the way, I just want to give you some new information, Eric, and you don't know this one yet, but you're getting ready to find it out. I now have the domain LoriAnderson.com. I do not have a web page yet, but if you type in LoriAnderson.com, it will go right now to my Google Plus page. These things that John puts out, or on the Courtroom Observers, I have different collections. I have Courtroom Observers collections, and I have Resurrect the Republic collections. And if you go and click in those collections, you will see what we're talking about. You will see the documents. You will see what we share with you on this radio show. So all you have to remember now, making it easy for everyone, is LoriAnderson.com or LoriAnderson.org. Either one will get you there. So, John, is there anything else that you would like to share? And we would also like to really thank you for everything you're doing. Without you, we couldn't get this information out to the people, and this is imperative for every one of us.
Thank you for having me on again. We got it any day now. Well, tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, we can have a verdict at any day, any moment. We'll try to let you know as soon as I have confirmation here that we're going to get a verdict or have a verdict. I'll try to let you guys know there, Eric and Lori.
Wonderful.
And we'll let you know, because it could happen anytime. So
wonderful. Yeah,
I'll be here on the ground. I'll be here on the ground till we get that verdict. I'm not leaving. So
well, we'll be keeping our eyes on you. We will be listening to your reports. I post them on my Google Plus. If y'all want to find John's reports, go to LoriAnderson.com. You can find it right there. And John, tell people how to follow you specifically as well.
You can definitely find me on Facebook. I do Facebook live streams multiple times a day as different important things come out of the court. That's under my name, just John Lamb, L-A-M-B. You can also find me on YouTube and multiple other places, but definitely on Facebook.
All righty. Well, John, thank you so very much for joining us this evening and updating us on what is going on. We look forward to having you on in the next couple
of
days.
You.
Hopefully there will be a long list of not guilty tomorrow. That would be great.
Yes. Well, keep us in your prayers. We need the prayers more than anything. Absolutely. Yes, Eric.
That's the most important thing. We're not going to win this without God on our side, and we do have the righteous high ground, and I think that's absolutely clear. What's going on, taking place, that the things that the enemy are doing are just absolutely grotesque. They couldn't stack the deck against the accused any more than they are, and these guys didn't even do anything. This is a victimless, once again, victimless statutory violations. John, do you think that the time that they're taking, the substantial amount of time to deliberate, it works in the favor of the accused? I think it does. I think the more time they take it, I think that it means they're going to get a better, at least a more fair shake. Would you agree with that?
I definitely do, and I feel really good about this one, because this trial here, and I know we didn't touch on it much today, maybe tomorrow or the next time I get on, I will touch on it more, but the juror questions had a lot to play in this trial and gave us a big insight on what the jurors were thinking. So far, we've had 144 juror questions in the last 5 weeks from the jurors. We've never had that before. They've never allowed the jurors to ask witnesses or the defense questions the way they have this time. So today, we had our 144th question from the jurors. And that has really gave us an insight of what these jurors are thinking.
Do you get the feeling that they're picking up on the scam that the witches' court is perpetrating against these people? I mean, I don't think they could miss it, you know? What do you think?
I definitely do. Whatever happened today, and we didn't get to hear the whole juror questions. Some of these juror questions the judge actually hides from us as observers. So she reads bits and pieces kind of in parables, but whichever one of the jurors wrote these two juror questions today, they were calling out two other jurors, and they were saying these jurors are biased and they must go. That's what happened in our not guilty verdict back there in Portland, Oregon. We got it back in 2016. There was a juror number 4, called out another juror number 11, and said, "Juror number 11 biased, and judge, you must remove her." We ended up removing that juror and had a not guilty verdict within an hour afterwards.
Absolutely. Wow. I remember that. Last we were question. All cheering on that.
Lord, let me get
same
the last
thing
question.
Happened here today.
Do you think, just your best guess, or if you know, tell us, but what's your guess? Was it the enemy asking that accused jurors be removed, or was it pro freedom jurors asking that, like, government bias witnesses be removed? Which way do you think that was?
We believe it was jurors on our side asking for these other two, because the two major jurors that got brought up is one of these jurors worked in the court system for 18 and a half years, and this other juror said that juror is biased. We want juror number 9 removed because she has worked 18 and a half years in the court system. The other juror number 6, anonymous juror wanted juror number 6 removed because juror number 6 had been involved in a gun pointed at her at one point in her life, and she was becoming biased and angry about the guns and stuff. So what we're seeing is the jurors, at least one other juror, if not all 10 of the others, they want these two jurors gone, because one juror question said, "We the jurors, we feel like juror number 9 is biased." That was one of the juror questions that came out today. We the jurors. So it's multiple jurors.
Wow. What happens if there's another mistrial?
The government can retry them. The chances of that, I guess we'll have to see. We know the government, these prosecutors, they have it out for these guys. But, you know, that's a big possibility. We're hoping and praying that that doesn't happen. And if it does, that the government just does the right thing and drops these charges.
Yeah,
or, you know, it depends on how many times they want to spend $100 million of taxpayer money to go after innocent people.
Well, last time we know that 7 of the 12 jurors said not guilty for sure. We know that because we did a juror pool of those jurors. So 7 said not guilty, 5 said guilty last time, and that's what made a miss. majority of the charges. This time right now, we're looking at 10 to 2.
All right. Well,
wow.
thank you, John.
Thank you so much for being with us. That's John Lamb, L-A-M-B. Find him on the Internet. He's the tall guy with the beard reporting, doing stellar work from the trials in Nevada. Thanks for being with us, John. Check in with us tomorrow or anytime, John. Appreciate you being with us.
Thank you. Right back.
Visit our website by going to publicbroadcasting.org.
Imagine a pill that can improve your focus, your memory, your sleep. A catalyst to improve your brain chemistry. Dr. Bill's Cognition Plus is truly the smarter in an hour pill. A combination of amino acids, trace minerals, and B vitamins, Cognition Plus is made with specialized herbal extracts that will enhance and support brain function. Our customers say,
I feel more focused.
My memory's getting better.
I can work longer with more useful hours.
Power up your neurotransmitters that have been depleted, like dopamine and norepinephrine. Stimulate the release of others, like serotonin and oxytocin. Improve circulation and energy production. Protect your mind and your loved ones today. Order Dr. Bill Deagle's Cognition Plus at 888-212-8871 or go online to NutriMedical.com. That's 888-212-8871 or NutriMedical.com.
This is Dr. Bill Deagle of the NutriMedical Report, 12 to 3, Monday to Friday. Call-ins are welcome to the show. You can order at 888-212-8871 or NutriMedical.com.
Homeowners, are you in foreclosure, expecting to be served with a foreclosure lawsuit, or suspect your lender has coerced you into an illegal mortgage transaction? A huge number of mortgages made in the last 10 years have legal issues and are possibly defective. State laws and the U.S. Supreme Court have upheld that defective mortgage documents are grounds for foreclosure defense and for counterclaims in favor of the homeowner. If your mortgage has been sold or assigned since closing the loan, it may be defective and you may be paying the wrong party, and the lender may not have standing or the right to foreclose or collect payments under the law. If you would like to know if your mortgage is legal or not, or know if you are paying the right party, we can help. Our initial consultations are free of charge. We are not attorneys. We are legal researchers and work closely with experienced lawyers who know how to help you find the evidence to help you keep your home. Call toll free 1-855-2-KEEP-IT. That's 1-855-2-KEEP-IT today.
Folks, we're living in a world the likes of which we've never perceived any clearer than we do now. The plan for global governance has been in the works for generations and would have likely been achieved by now but for the fact that the globalists left open their Achilles heel. With all their tools, Federal Reserve System, fiat currency, No Child Left Behind, and then Common Core education introduced to our schools to dumb us down, vaccines, pharmaceuticals to lobotomize us, GMO foods, insertion of compromised or bought and paid for politicians, judges, mainstream media propaganda, all pieced together like a puzzle designed to ultimately bring the world under submission. But with all their strategy, they forgot one thing: knowledge. And knowledge is power. With knowledge, their bombardment is nullified. Folks, with that, as brilliant and knowledgeable as you've become, among the wisest audience of any radio audience in the world, and you are, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, how much of that knowledge did I obtain from Republic Broadcasting Network? How high has my consciousness been raised since I've been a listener? How fast am I now able to discriminate truth from fake news by being a Republic Broadcasting listener? How clear am I now able to see the world since I've been listening to RBN? Ask yourselves those questions, folks. Then ask yourself, what is that knowledge worth to me? Like my morning coffee, how would I survive without it? A voice of truth in a sea of lies. Do we not all need to make sure it survives? Like public broadcasting, we are now finding we can only survive with listener support. Censorship, advertisers being attacked, truth itself being attacked. It's the only way through this. We at Republic Broadcasting humbly ask you to become a supporter. Look at your budget and make a determination of what Republic Broadcasting is worth to you and what you can afford on a monthly basis. Go to republicbroadcasting.org and pledge 20, 30, 40, 50, if possible, 100 a month or more if it's affordable. Click the donate button and become a regular monthly donor. Assure both us and yourself that Republic Broadcasting truth will continue to flow like that morning coffee. The network thanks you.
Try not to get worried, try not to turn on to problems that upset you. Well, don't you know everything's alright? Yes, everything's fine, and we want you to sleep well tonight. Let the world turn without you tonight. If we try, we'll get by, so forget all about us tonight.
Everything's alright, yes, everything's alright, yes.
Sleep and I shall soothe you, calm you and anoint you. Therefore you're not far better. Then you feel everything's alright, yes, everything's fine. And it's cool and the ointment's sweet.
My friends, welcome back to the broadcast. Thanks for joining us tonight. I tell you, this broadcast tonight, it's not because of me, but the broadcast tonight and Friday have been absolutely fantastic because of Evelyn and our guests, Gary and Chris on Friday, and with John Lamb and Laurie Anderson tonight. I would highly recommend people post these shows everywhere you can so people can hear what's really going on in this country. Tuning into these other networks and listening to talk about Afghanistan and how we're having a build down. One of the other talk show hosts on another network, the big one, said we're having a build down in Afghanistan. I guess it's this bizarre thing where troops are increasing, but we're getting out of it. We're winding it down. It reeks of the Masons to me. That's their idiotic, oxymoronic doublespeak. We have words that are totally in opposite, like constructive possession. There's no such thing as constructive possession. Tom Lacovara was not in possession of any firearm.
Right.
Lori, it's been so nice to have you and John on tonight. Hopefully we're going to have John on and Lori on again tomorrow. Lori's with us for the rest of the broadcast, I hope, Lori. There's only 20 minutes left, so hopefully you're not going anywhere. But I want to talk. Hang in there till the end if you can. What is Gary in Michigan with us? I'd like to get a prayer if we can before we get too close to the end. What's that, Mike? Gary. Gary, are you on mute, my sir? We need you from Michigan. Where are you, Gary?
This is Gary Don. I was on mute. I was talking to myself.
I do that all the time.
I've done that before.
Hey, how are you tonight? Gary, I'm sorry to make you wait so long, but we had John Lamb on, and we wanted to get were you listening to anything that he was talking about that comes, something scriptural comes to mind, and then a prayer?
Yeah, I listened very carefully, and, of course, I followed the Bundy as close as I can from the standpoint here of being in the thumb of Michigan. We are. It's also an evil state here. What state isn't evil anymore? Right. I just picked up on a little bit. I was hearing some from Laurie and John, a little situation about the Constitution and different things. And you and I have, and Chris have been talking about the protocols of the Learned Elders of Zion. And I thought this was just the perfect 11. There's all through the protocols. It's all the different things. But this really will explain why the law is like it is in these courts. This is protocol number 11. I won't read the whole thing because it takes too long. This is programming of the new Constitution. What new Constitution, huh? Mm-hmm. Certain details of the proposed revolution. The Goyim, that's Israelites who they call Goyim, which is cattle of the field, folks. I'm sure most people know that. A pack of sheep, secret masonry, and show lodges. Mm-hmm. It says the state council has been as it were, the emphatic expression of the authority of the ruler. It will be as he show part of the legislative corpse, what may be called the editorial committees of law, laws, and degrees of the ruler. And it goes on and on and talks about there's going to be there, and there then is a propaganda of the new constitution. We shall, the learned elders of Zion, the Jews, we shall make law, capital L, right, capital R, and justice, capital J, one in the guise of proposal to the legislative corpse. Two, by decree of the president under the guise of general regulations of orders of the Senate and of the resolutions of the state council. And it goes on and on and on. And then, of course, you have a whole section on the war. So with that, we'll just close off in a prayer. And our Father, we come thanking you for blessings you give us. We first must ask, as we're looking as the Day of Atonement coming on us 40 days from after this great eclipse day, we're going to follow the Day of Atonement in 40 days. And Father, as you did in Jonah's time, you give the people 40 days to bring forth and ask their forgiveness of their sins against you and the law. And our Father, we know for sure that as we become more learned in the scriptures and the things that you ask us that you would like to have us do with your land and with our neighbors and not charging usury to our neighbors, we know we have been part of this sinful activity that was against the laws of you, the creator of all things, Father. And we know that the churches have taught us that the law has been done away with, hung on a cross somewhere. And Father, we know this is not true. And it's because of our disannulling ourselves to the law that we need to come asking you for the forgiveness of the sins as we find out the truths of the law that should be brought upon in the house of Israel. And as we go forward, as we pray for the Bundys, Father, we ask that they'd strengthen them. We'd ask, Father, that you might coerce by the softening of the hearts of the people and bring forth those who can speak on behalf of the right thing to do. We ask, Father, that all things would be in the favor of the Bundys, and that you would your presence would be the presence in that court. And we know there will be a payday someday, no matter how they find the guilties, the Bundys to guilty or not guilty. There will be a punishment, and they will be punished. There will be the long arm of justice. And so we ask this all in Yodi Vahi's name, so be it.
Beautiful. Thank you, Gary. That was wonderful. Fantastic. Lori?
Yes. Well, I just want to give some announcements, and thank you, Gary, for that. And I've missed you as well. I just want to put that out there. But I wanted to give everybody, you know, we've covered quite a bit of the negative, but I want to give everybody a warning of some things, because we try to warn our listeners too. If other things are going on and we know about it, it's our duty to tell you about it so you can be warned. So one of my elderly neighbors, whom I will not name, called me over to talk to me the other day. There is a phone number, and I'm going to give you the number to write down, so please get a pen and paper, because this is actually important. My elderly neighbor is in her later 80s, early 90s. She has heart problems, and it made her chest hurt and made it where she couldn't sleep. This is a scam call, hoax situation. They're claiming to be the IRS. So I'll tell you the situation in a second. I'm going to give you the number to write down. It's 954-507-1307. I'm going to repeat that number. 954-507-1307. Now, the caller that called her claimed his name, it was a male, claimed his name was John Walker. More than likely, that is not his name. And more than likely, there is more than one person involved in this. When I did a reverse search on this, it came up as a VOIP number out of Coral Springs, Florida. A lot of other individuals had put on the reverse search in the white pages that they had also been threatened. So let me tell you what happened to my elderly neighbor. She called me over and was upset and asked me. She had no unearthly idea why the IRS would be calling her. So she asked me, she said, can you check into this? Because I haven't been able to sleep. Her chest has been hurting already. She just got through with surgeries just this past year. And she told me that this person claiming to be John Walker was on the phone with her. And he told her that she was had scammed, basically scammed the IRS, owed the IRS money. If she hung up on him, that the police would be knocking at her door. She would immediately be taken away into jail. And she was in panic mode. She didn't know what to do. This individual is trying to pry for information. What is your name? What is your address? And so forth. Now, some of our elderly that listen to the program that don't necessarily use the internet, per se, or some of the elderly don't know about a lot of these scammers. And it could potentially be fatal for some of the elderly that have health problems and they're receiving threats over the phone. So immediately I told her, I said, well, because of how he handled it, and I had asked her if she had received any paperwork or anything like that. No, she hadn't. And so I immediately began to do my searching. And that is when I found out this has been going on with quite a lot of people. It's listed. Not everybody lists it under that number. But when individuals do reverse searches, when it comes to white pages, some people take the time to make the comments under there so people are aware when they reverse search on a number.
What address or entity is registered to that number or is associated with that number?
Here's the problem. Nothing. The only thing that came up with that number was moderate spam, IRS fraud. It did not give an exact location, but it did give Coral Springs, Florida. So I'm going to ask any of our anonymous listeners or any of our whizzes out there that are under my voice, if you can find any information about this number so that we could actually get this to law enforcement where they can actually do a real job to stop the potential of elderly having heart attacks over stuff like this, please, by all means, 954-507-1307. We need to find out who this is. It's a VOIP number. I was unable to find out anything else.
Lori, you got to give that number out. Listen, hold on. So let me condense this for people in case they got confused. There's some entity out of Coral Springs, Florida that's calling elderly people and scamming them to the point where Lori's neighbor is having a heart attack over it, threatening them with jail, and you got to send us this money and all this, that. Of course, we're going to our listeners at the RBN Network. I, Eric the Freedom Screamer, hereby deputize everybody out there to be an investigative reporter for courtroomwatch.com. And so now you can go out and you're an investigative reporter to use your computer skills to find out what entity or address or anything is associated with the following number, because this is the number that the people, someone apparently named John Walker, but we're assuming that's most likely not his real name.
Right.
If
right.
It is, boy, is he stupid. But it's probably not. So, but we want to know who's tied to this number, and we want any of our three-letter agency friends out there who are listening to this broadcast to
that's
get
right.
your rear end off. Listen to the rebroadcast of this tomorrow, and right now get out and do your job and find out
right.
who's scamming the old people claiming to be the IRS.
Right.
I mean,
and they told her Yeah, and they told her that she had $3,000, and if she didn't pay by Friday, she was going to be in jail. So this you know, and this runs under FCC because it crossed state lines. That's all I'm going to say. So, and it was over the phone lines. And according to whitepages.com, when you type in that number, do it yourself. Remember, verify everything I'm saying. Type in that number under White Pages, do reverse search. You will see that other people from all across our union have also posted this as they were threatening and they were doing things. So,
Lori, read the number slowly, like twice or three times. So everybody get your pen out. Here's the number we want everybody to track down. This is our group project for the evening on tomorrow.
Absolutely.
Call us with the report tomorrow, folks. See where the computers goes. Go ahead, Lori. Slowly, the number.
Okay, so the number is 954-507-1307. The fictitious name, we're assuming it's a fictitious name. It may be the true name, but I doubt it seriously. He goes by John Walker. The number
again
is 954-507-1307. And I would also ask, if you see that number come up on your phone, if you have a recording device where you can record this call, record it. Because we have to do our best, you know, not only just in exposing what's going on with the Bundy trials and everything that we try to expose for you all, but this is part of our duty to help protect our neighbors and our people here within the United States of America. What does happen if it's one of these elderly and they do end up having a heart attack? Who's going to be held accountable? So, you know, they may see it as just a scam, but then it can get really a lot deeper than that, and there are victims to this. So I feel it is my duty to get this information out there. Once again, the number is 954-507-1307. Let's see what you guys can find out for me and for all the people who may be victim to this number. The gentleman goes by John Walker, or at least the one that called my elderly neighbor did. So I also wanted to give, earlier in the show, since we only have about 9 minutes, Eric, I want to finish my story because it actually is really relevant to one of the things that I'll let everybody look up for themselves. They will find it on my Google Plus under Resurrect the Republic Collection. I'll post it in there so they can read the whole thing. But my story about when I called the Senate, when I called one of my senators, and this was years back because they were wanting to implement more background check type situations on whether the ATF would approve or disapprove of anyone having a gun. Not that they're really truly allowed to do that anyway, but I asked an honest question. And I asked her this. I said, I have an honest question for you. For this background check, it would be approved or disapproved by the ATF, is that correct, in this bill? Yes, that is correct. And you should absolutely shoot down this bill no matter what. Because let me ask you a question. Would you ask a criminal permission to do anything? She said no. I said, the ATF has been caught running guns to known criminals, to drug cartels across the borders, violating not only our laws, but international laws. And you're asking me to get permission from a criminal on whether I can have a firearm or not. I don't think so. So with that being said, she agreed with that. She said, I understand your point. Do you? Why would you have me submit any of my information to someone who does business with drug cartels? I'm not a criminal. I don't seek criminals' permission for anything. Certainly not if I can defend myself. So if my computer does not go down, which they have really been attacking me tonight, guys, really bad. But it was just reported on the 18th. The Department of Justice is ending Operation Choke Point. If you remember Operation Choke Point, that was when, during the Obama administration, they were using Operation Choke Point targeting by the FDIC in order to shut down gun sales and businesses. This is what was reported. The Department of Justice announced in a letter on Friday that it had ended all activities associated with Operation Choke Point. In a written letter to the House Judiciary Committee, Assistant Attorney General Sessions, my computer just went blank. So what I will have to do, oh, here we go. I apologize, the termites really like messing with me when I'm on the show. They don't like me talking, do they, Eric?
Oh, not at all. Welcome to the club of technical interference. Yes, the life of an activist is always interesting. Hey, trying to get
God
stuff done on the computer is a chore.
Well, you know, God
you
love them. They do try so hard. I did.
Okay, continue.
So, if it doesn't go down again, I will actually read this to you. It is really trying hard not to let me get this information out to you, but it is important for you to hear it. It is important, and of course they don't want this out. Okay, so in a written letter to the House Judiciary Committee, the Assistant Attorney General Stephen Boyd called the program a misguided initiative conducted during the previous administration and promised the Department of Justice was no longer pursuing it. Now, I hope all law enforcement that is listening to this, whether you're state, local, town, county, federal, please listen to this because it has been stopped. And it says, all the department's bank investigations conducted as part of Operation Choke Point are now over. The initiative is no longer in effect and it will not be undertaken again, Boyd said. The Department of Justice went on to say that it would no longer engage in investigations motivated by, quote, political preferences, unquote, and specifically said that it would not target the financial dealings of otherwise lawful members of the short-term lending and firearms industries. Quote, the department is committed to bringing enforcement actions only where warranted by the facts and the applicable law without regard to political preferences, unquote. Boyd said in the letter, this approach honors the department's fundamental obligation to focus on the lawbreakers that deserve our undivided attention and thereby protect the American public from fraud and other criminal activity. We reiterate that the department will not discourage the provision of financial services to lawful industries, including businesses engaged in short-term lending and firearms-related activities, unquote. The House Judiciary Committee Chairman Bob Goodlatte, Republican of Virginia, cheered the Department of Justice decision and blamed the Obama administration for creating the program. He said, we applaud the Trump Justice Department for decisively ending Operation Choke Point, he said. The Obama administration created this ill-advised program to suffocate legitimate businesses, to which it was ideologically opposed by intimidating financial institutions into denying banking services to those businesses. Targeted industries such as firearms dealers were presumed guilty by the Obama Justice Department until proven innocent, and many businesses are still facing the repercussions of this misguided program. This is no way for law enforcement to operate and runs counter to principles enshrined in our Constitution, unquote. Gun rights activists and those of the financial service industry were equally pleased with the DOJ's announcement. The National Rifle Association credited President Trump with rolling back the program, saying that it was, quote, the latest in a long line of Trump administration successes in rolling back the failed policies of the Obama administration, unquote. They call Operation Choke Point unconscionable and said it was aimed at destroying firearms-related businesses. So, on that note, I will leave the link in my Google+. Find me at LoriAnderson.com. It'll take you right there. And as always, everyone, thank you for allowing me to join you tonight. As always, watch your back. Check your facts, Semper Fi Dallas, and have a wonderful night.
Thank you, Lori. Appreciate y'all joining us tonight. We'll see you tomorrow night. This is Eric the Freedom Screamer. Thank you, Gary. Thank you, Lori. Thank you, John Lamb. Thank you, all our callers, and we will see you tomorrow night on the Republic Broadcasting Network. Have a good evening.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Good night. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Mike.